This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we have two problems. In problem one, we will calculate the mechanical energy of a vertical elastic pendulum, while in problem two, we will study the motion of a block using the mechanical energy and the work energy theorem.
Let's go to problem one. A vertical spring of natural length L0 is fixed to the ceiling from its upper end. A ball is attached to the lower end of the spring, and then it is released from rest. Now take a look at the given. The natural length of the spring is 50 cm, the force constant is 20 Newton per meter, the mass of the ball is 0.2 kg, and the gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared. Now consider the figure. The figure shows the ball in a certain position, and we take the ground as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. Question number one. Determine in this position the mechanical energy of the system ball spring Earth. As you know, this is the formula of the mechanical energy in this situation. Me is equal to Ke plus GPE plus EPE. Now this is going to be Me is equal to 1/2 mv squared plus mgz plus 1/2 k delta L squared. But what is delta L? Look at the figure. Delta L is the final length L minus the natural or the original length L0. Now let's go to the numerical application. Start with the kinetic energy. The mass is 0.2 kg. The speed is 1 meter per second. Now go to the gravitational potential energy. The mass is 0.2 kg. The gravitational acceleration is 10. And Z is 30 centimeters, so we divide it by 100, it becomes 0.3 meter. You know that meter is the SI unit of altitude. Now go to the elastic potential energy. The force constant is 20 Newton per meter, and delta L is equal to L minus L0, and the final length is 60 centimeters, so it becomes 0.6 meter. And the natural length is 50 centimeters, so it becomes 0.5 meter, and this is going to be 0.8 joule.
Question number two. Determine the mechanical energy of the system ball spring Earth at T0 equals zero, which is the instant at which we release the ball from rest. Okay, at T0 equals zero, the length of the spring is equal to its natural length, so its delta L is zero, or we have no variation in the length of the spring. Then the elastic potential energy in the spring is zero. Also, since the ball starts from rest at T0 equals zero, so we have no speed and no kinetic energy. The only form of energy possessed by the system at T0 equals zero is the gravitational potential energy. So the gravitational potential energy depends on the altitude of the ball. Using the figure, the altitude of the ball at T0 equals zero, which is Z0, equals Z plus delta L. Z is given, which is 30 centimeters, and delta L calculated in the previous part, which is 10 centimeters. Then the altitude of the ball at T0 equals zero relative to the reference level equals 0.4 meters. Then, using the formula of the gravitational potential energy, mgz0, then substitute for m equals 0.2, g equals 10, and z of 0 equals 0.4. Therefore, the gravitational potential energy at T0 equals 0 is 0.8 joules. Going to the formula of the mechanical energy, which is Ke plus EPE plus GPE, as we said, Ke equals 0, EPE equals 0, and GPE equals 0.8. Finally, the mechanical energy of the system at T0 equals 0 equals 0.8 joules.
Now let's move to problem 2. A block as taken as a particle of mass m equal 2 kilograms is released from rest from point A of the track ABC in the vertical plane. The horizontal plane containing BC is taken as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. Now, we have these values. The mass of the block is 2 kilograms. The speed at point A is 0, sine alpha is 0.2. The length of track AB is 4 meters and that of BC is 10 meters. The gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared. Now, part 1. Neglect the friction along AB, so track AB is frictionless. Now, determine the speed of the block as it reaches point B using, first, the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. Now, when solving questions using the principle of conservation of mechanical energy, so the chosen system must include the Earth. So our system is as Earth. Now, apply the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. So we have MEA is equal to MEB. This is going to be GPEA plus KEA is equal to GPEB plus KEB. Now, GPEA is MGZA. KEA is 0 because S is released from rest at point A. GPEB is 0 because S is at the reference level at point B. And finally, KEB is 1/2 MVB squared. Now this is going to be VB is equal to the square root of 2GZA. But now, how can we calculate ZA? Consider the right angled triangle on the figure. So where is ZA? Now, if you take sine alpha, it would be the opposite ZA over the hypotenuse AB. So ZA is equal to AB sine alpha. So ZA is equal to AB sine alpha. Now, let's move to the numerical application. So VB is equal to the square root of 2 times G, the gravitational acceleration, AB, the length of the track, it's 4 meters, and sine alpha, 0.2, and the answer will be 4 meters per second.
Focus, please. This is important.
Part B. We have to determine the speed of S as it reaches point B, but by using the work energy theorem. When using the work energy theorem, we take S as the system. So, what are the external forces acting on S during its motion? These forces, or the external forces, are the weight, which is vertically downward, and the normal reaction N, which is normal to the surface of the incline. Applying the work energy theorem, delta Ke from A to B, which is KEB minus KEA, equal the sum of the work done by the external forces acting on S. So, KEB equal 1/2 MVB squared, KEA equal 1/2 MVA squared, equal the work done by the weight plus the work done by the normal reaction. We know that N is normal or perpendicular to the direction of motion. So, its work is zero. And the work done by the weight is given by mg into ZA minus ZB. ZA is the initial height and ZB is the final height of S. If we take B as a reference, so ZB equals 0, then the work done by the weight equals mg into ZA minus 0. But ZA is calculated in the previous part. ZA equals AB sine 30 as calculated in the previous part. Now, 1/2 MVB squared minus 0, which is KE at A, equal MGAB sine alpha. Divide by M both sides. This is going to be 1/2 VB squared minus 0 equal G, which is 10. We substitute for G equal 10, for AB equal 4, and sine alpha equal 0.2. After some calculation, we get Vb equal 4 meters per second.
Now let's move to part 2. The block continues its motion along BC and reaches point C with a speed whose value is 2 meters per second. The question is, determine the variation in the mechanical energy of the system as Earth between B and C. As you know, the variation in the mechanical energy is delta ME, which is equal to MEC minus MEB. Now, MEC is the final mechanical energy and MEB is the initial mechanical energy. Now, this is going to be KEC plus GPEC minus KEB plus GPEB. Now, 1/2 MVC squared is the kinetic energy at point C. GPEC and GPEB are both zero because S is at the reference level in these two positions. And finally, KEB is equal to 1/2 MVB squared. Now, rearrange. This is going to be 1/2 M into VC squared minus VB squared. Let's go to the numerical application. So delta ME is equal to 1/2 into 2, the mass of the block, and VC is 2 meter per second. And VB, as you know, it is calculated in the first part, it is 4 meter per second. So the answer is minus 12 joules.
Part 2b, deduce that track BC exerts a friction on S. How can we prove that the track BC exerts friction? We know that the friction is a non-conservative force. Its square results in the decrease in the mechanical energy. We have proved that in the previous part that the mechanical energy decreases as S moves from B to C. Since the mechanical energy at C less than that at B, so the track BC exerts friction on S. 2C. Determine the constant magnitude of the friction force exerted by BC on S. Using this formula, the variation in the mechanical energy between B and C equal to the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces. But the friction force is the only non-conservative force that does work during the motion of S between B and C. So delta ME from B to C equal the work done by the friction. But the work done by a friction equal F scalar BC as S moves between B and C. F scalar BC equal the magnitude of F times the magnitude of BC or the length or the distance BC times cosine the angle between F and BC. As we see, the angle between F and BC equal 180 degree since F is opposite to the direction of the motion, but cosine 180 equal minus 1. So the work done by the friction equal minus F times BC. Going back to the formula, delta ME from B to C equal minus F times BC. So substitute delta ME equal minus 12 as proved or calculated in part 2a, so minus 12 equal minus F times 10, BC equal 10 meter. Therefore, the magnitude of the friction force equal 1.2 newtons.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.